So today the title is How Deep Is Your Width? When we think about width, then there is one icon in the Bible, and that is Joseph. Joseph is the icon of being with God. And we are also with God because we are saved. And there might be different steps of being with God. There will be different levels of being with God. For example, if I am with somebody else in the same space, and that is also width. And if somebody is right next to me, that is also width. And if we are eating together, we are width. And if we are just a family, then that is also one concept of being with. And if we are possessing the same plan or same goal together, that is also being with together. Christ being together with us, that is the eternal concept of being together, but it's not the level of being together in one space. So in the pulpy message, we heard that God's with us is just like the cuddle of a mom. And cuddle of a mom is, I think that is the best expression that we can describe how to be with somebody in our level. So that is humans, the safest and the warmest place. And what's important here is when you think about the mother's cuddle, you should not think about your biological mother, because this is just a figure of speech, or it's a metaphor. So we have to find out the hidden meaning of it when we see the analogy. So out of so many steps of being with, to the extent where the wilderness feels like the mother's cuddle, there is deep level of width. So that was Joseph's width. But when we think about mother, some wise mothers, they don't allow everything. They say when something is not okay, then they say no. That is the wise mother. So what God gave us was the blood. The method is the blood. No other way. He didn't allow it. And all the disasters were finished with that blood. And what God gave to us to enjoy as our today is the worship. So that's why those who did not understand the worship, they were just strictly right away buried in the wilderness. And those who obeyed in faith till the end, they were absolutely always firmly established as the disciples, and they were always standing in front of the world and in front of the posterity with their witness, with their evidences. So those figures were Joseph and Moses, and in the book of Numbers, Joshua and Caleb. But how about now? Just like those people who applied the blood on the doorpost, they had the exodus. Now we believe in Jesus as our Savior, who finished everything on the cross and who resurrected. So his finishing everything on the cross is our beginning. So as they applied the blood on the doorpost, we hold on to Jesus Christ's name and call on his name. And that's when our disaster and fate and destiny, all the curses are over. But sometimes we think that I still have my disaster, I still have my curses, and I still have my problems. And here is the reason why. The reason is I don't know what kind of fate and destiny I am still in. So that's why I cannot find myself. That's why I cannot break free from it. Even if those curses are finished, I don't see that as the fate and destiny. That's why I am still in there. Let me take it as an example, my testimony. I was a person who was really lethargic. When it comes to being lethargic, I was the number one who was always mentioned. When you feel lethargic, you don't want to go out. And I was like that. There was no special reason. I just didn't want to go out. It was serious to the extent where I wake up in the morning and I get dressed, I put on my makeup, and then I'm so ready to go out, but I don't go out. I just sink, and then I cannot move. So there's no specific reason to make excuses. So what I could do was just hiding. I had to hide and make up with lies. I had to procrastinate, and people feel like she's doing nothing, but I was busy inside because I was being afflicted. It's not my personality, but it was the spiritual problem. What is the difference between the personality and the spiritual problem? When it comes to the spiritual problem, you know that you should not do this, but you are already doing it, and you want to stop it, but you cannot stop it. So until I discovered it, it had taken such a long time, because I didn't know what I was being deceived by. So only when you continue to listen to the word of God can you discover that. And once you discover it, from that time on, it will be a little bit easier, because when you discover what Satan uses as his weapon to me, then you will be less deceived by that. And when you realize that this is the spiritual thing, and then hold on to the name of Jesus Christ, that Jesus who finished everything on the cross 2,000 years ago comes into effect right away with me, with my problem. So that name works even now at this moment. So how blessed are we? We are such a blessed ones to know this spiritual fact, knowing Jesus Christ's name and calling his name, and that is having the power of creation in me, the power of liberation just like Exodus in me, the power of forgiveness is in me, and the light to save all the world is in me. So when you stop listening to the word of God, like when you think you're okay without listening to the word of God, then you will not be able to see how the spiritual problem is plowing into your personal problem, or how your family's spiritual problem and national spiritual problem has been settled down in me. You will not be able to see that. So without looking at that, you have to just dismiss it like, oh, this is our culture. Oh, this is what we do. Oh, it's just my personality. You have to say that. That is how we confine God's power within my box. So within that box, within that boundary, we just believe in Jesus as big as the box. So it's unfair, isn't it? God is the unlimited one. He is God of infinity. So I sometimes feel sorry when I talk about this, but when I see some people, they say that they are from the Christian country and they say that they are Christians, they believe in Jesus, and they don't worship, and they work on Sunday. And sorry, but they don't know what the spiritual things are. They don't believe the spiritual work. They do not understand even the single thing about the spirituality. And then they just chose Jesus as one of the many religions. So even if those people go to church, their life is not overwhelmed or governed by the word of God. So it means we have no spiritual experience. It's not something that we can just cover up and then, you know, sweep it under the rug and forget about it, but be sincere and see exactly where we are. We need to know currently our current address, because that's what exactly Satan wants. Satan wants us to sweep it under the rug and pretend that we don't have it. So we are this blessed one, but this blessing is only found through the interpretation. It depends on how to interpret my life with the word of God. But this interpretation usually takes place with the people around me. So think about it. When you have the problem, you have to tell it to your people, like friends and family, and then you talk about it. And that's how we share our forum over the things. Like, that's how we get to the conclusion of, oh, this is why this happened. And then we try to seek the answer for that. So that's why people around you are really important. Who do I hang out with? That's really important. For example, when I have a problem, there are two ways to interpret it. Physical way and a spiritual way. So what interpretation you listen to first matters the most. So that's why when you have something important, do not talk with any person. Do not listen to anything, like, you know, any random thing. Or do not just speak anything as your confession. the first interpretation that you have to listen to is what God says. What does God say about this incident? What is God's interpretation regarding this matter? So that is the worshiper. The one who resort to God when I need an interpretation about something, that person is the worshiper. When it comes to worship, don't put the significance on coming to the church itself, but you have to make the resolution that today I'm going to find the answer of my life, the conclusion of my life. That is a resolution that you have to come to on Sunday. Like, you don't know whether this will be your last Sunday or this will be your, you know, one of the many Sundays. So this Sunday, this Lord's Day, comes only one time in my whole life. So that's why we have to find real conclusion of my life in every single worship. Because when we make the resolution, that attitude, that kind of mindset or posture sometimes keeps you from listening to something, or sometimes allows you to listen to something important. So that attitude is the attitude of faith and obedience. When you think about coming to church, when you come to church and listen to the Word of God, it's not just for your own sake. When you, one person, comes to life, that's when God's plan toward you can be fulfilled. And that is also fulfilled in my children, in my family line, and in my region. So those people who cannot feel the world evangelization as my covenant, those people can think that he or she has not come to life yet. So when you feel that God is cuddling me, God is cuddling me just like my parents, when you listen to the Word of God, then you will have the assurance of what God will do with my life. That means in your soul, you don't feel yourself who is foolish, but Almighty God is felt in your soul. So one day, when I lose hold of it again at some point, and when I look at myself who is weak and foolish, then at that moment, the evangelism will sound like a joke. Like, how can I do the evangelism? So when you understand that, oh, I am called as the evangelism disciple, that is only possible when you find God's word believable without looking at yourself. These three things are only believed when the word of God is heard to you, and when the word of God is believed by you, when you find it really believable. So how can I not look at myself? I am in this reality, and I know that I am lacking, and things are not taking place to me. How can I not be deceived by myself? To the extent where I do not see myself any longer, we have to edit the word of God in me unceasingly. God planned the salvation, and he really sent the Christ, and the Holy Spirit is with the one who is believing it, and that is the general fact. That's just the truth and the fact. I believe it, you believe it, and everybody believes it. But how is this truth edited in myself? And that is my message. That determines what platform I am. So what kind of platform am I? Without the Word of God being edited as my own message, God cannot use me as a platform. So that's very much important. We need to have my own message that I can relay whoever I meet. So it cannot be just fabricated by, you know, in today, like all of a sudden. We have to organize the Word of God every week and find the realization and connect it as our prayer topic. That is how to edit our life, edit our Word of God. We need this process of organizing and realizing and holding on to it as our prayer topic. So Joseph didn't talk about it. Joseph didn't say that the Lord is with me, but his width was seen to others. So he was a kind of person who was completely edited by the word of God, the things of God. He had such a sure covenant that it was even physically, not physically, but literally felt and seen to others. And then we plan with our prayer. When you just think about this topic, when you just think about it, it becomes your prayer. Sometimes the answer comes to us visibly, like physically, but that is more like a confirmation, like, oh, this is really fulfilled this way. So it's confirmation of the word of God. But really overwhelming answer is being able to listen to the sermon as God's voice. Like, God is really telling me. When you feel that, that is the true overwhelming answer. That means finally you and God, I and God are communicating. We are speaking the same language. Now that you receive and discover God's voice, so you can settle down your heart, fix your heart, and make the resolution. That's when we stand as the bartizan or the watchtower that God uses. And this time schedule doesn't just come all of a sudden. It needs our morning and night. Let me put it, thoughts. In morning and night, I need my time of deeply, deeply being with God. Bring this word and enter into the deep time. But what usually bothers us is the thought. So the standard of being deep is till the point where I do not be bothered by my thoughts any longer. My thoughts just disappears and God's word is fully in me. That moment is the moment of depth. So that's how deep we should enter. And then our life will be designed with the church. When God is with us, He gave us one way of being with us, visible way, in a visible way, and that is the church. Church is the model of the heaven, and that means the things pertaining to the kingdom of God is fulfilled through the churches, because this is the model of the church. So in the work of the church, I have to become the main figure of the answer. That is, we are planning 600 regional churches and intensive training. In Songtan, we have our regional churches, and now in the intensive training and intensive schools and also the new members class, we are all attending. And after each intensive training and concentration, there comes the next time schedule. So I believe that our multi-ethnic groups will, group members will stand as a disciples through all these intensive training. And about the missions, this contact-free service and World Missions Convention. We are praying for it, and we are preparing also our physical offering too to support the missionaries who will come for the training. And the third thing that we have to pray for is our pastorate, like TCKs, and especially we recently opened a regional church in our Songxin Elementary School. So I gave it a thought, and then I'm pretty sure that in this school and around this school, we are the only ones, like only team who tries to evangelize. So we provide our house and they go to school for the sake of evangelism. I think those kids are the only ones who go to school not for study, but to evangelize. So how would God be not be pleased by that? I believe that God's greatest interest is with us. So remember that. We added the word of God in us, and this is how. And we plan our life with a prayer. And the point of going deep is until I am not seized by my thoughts any longer. And God's work is fulfilled through the church, and that's how we design our life, put our life into this evangelism and missions and posterity movement. And when we go back to Joseph, Joseph had no mother. He lost his mother when he was really little. And what he enjoyed was being with God that those with mother could not find, could not enjoy. So do you think your life is missing something? Or do you think you need something more than that? Then you have to understand this way. God wants to give you something that you cannot enjoy with what you wish to have. So without those things, you are fine. It is sufficient. We give thanks, and then we will discover what God wants to give me in this situation. So there is the evangelism and mission that only this multi-ethnic group can do. Only I can do. There is God's work only you can do. So in your time of concentration, may you really discover that with the one and only worship tomorrow. So may you begin that answer. I will pray for that. Let's pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you. We believe and confess that when we are with you, Lord, we do not need anything else. Let us discard all the unnecessary things and enjoy being with you deeper and deeper every day. From today on, we want to enjoy the worship where we edit our own word, plan in our prayer, and become the witness of recreation designed through our church. Help us discover the missions only we can do. We pray in Jesus Christ's name.